Hello everyone, welcome to this video. In this video, we shall be looking at another theorem from Banach algebras. So, from previous results and previous lectures, we know that spectral radius, which is represented by this r sigma of x, where x is some element coming from the Banach algebra, and r sigma represents the spectral radius. It is defined by taking the supremum of all the absolute values of lambdas, where all the lambdas they come from the spectrum set. So that means the maximum modulus value of the maximum modulus spectral value is basically your spectral radius. So based on this, we have another result which says that this spectral radius is bounded, and it is bounded by the norm of x. So how? The theorem here says that if you have A as any complex Banach algebra which also has an identity E, then in that case the spectrum is compact. This is first thing, that sigma of x is compact, and moreover the spectral radius satisfies this property. So how do we prove something, some set to be compact set? A set, so by definition, if you remember, a set is compact if it is bounded and continuous, bounded and closed. So this is the definition for a set to be a compact set. So let's see how can we use this thing in order to prove this result. So first of all, we will prove that the spectral radius is bounded, right? So for that, if we take this mod of lambda greater than the norm of x, then what do we have? We can shift this quantity to right hand side so that we have this thing, and now we can write 1 by mod of lambda to be mod of lambda inverse. So now we can combine this using the properties of norm, so this would be norm of lambda inverse x. So from here we can see that the norm of lambda inverse x, that thing is strictly less than 1. So we have this result. If the norm of something is less than 1, so therefore using this result, which we already know in the Banach complex Banach algebra having identity, if norm of x is less than 1, then e minus x is invertible and its expansion is given by the equation star that we already know. So in this case, lambda inverse x has norm less than 1, so that means the element e minus lambda inverse x is invertible in this case. So using this thing here, because this is invertible, so if we multiply this element by minus lambda, that would be invertible also. So in this case, if you multiply this by minus lambda, so what do you get? You get x minus lambda e. So this element x minus lambda e is also invertible. If this element is invertible, so that means, now according to the definition for resolvent set in Banach algebra, the element lambda, the complex value, complex number lambda, that belongs to the resolvent set rho of x, or for the element x in Banach algebra. So that means you say, when and this thing was true whenever we consider this thing, that the absolute value for lambda is strictly greater than the norm of x. So using this thing over here, we say that whenever the absolute value of lambda is strictly greater than the norm of x, so that implies lambda belongs to the resolvent set of x. Or if you take the complement of this whole of this thing, that means in here we are saying this is the modulus of lambda is strictly greater than norm of x, so its complement would be modulus of lambda less than or equal to norm of x. So wherever we have this condition, the lambda would belong to the complement of this set, the resolvent set, which is the spectrum set. So according to The second condition here, which we have proved, whenever mod of lambda is less than equal to norm of x, we have lambda contained in the spectrum set. That gives you the definition for spectral set, because the we know the supremum of every lambda here has magnitude less than equal to norm of x. So its supremum would also have the magnitude less than equal to x. So that means the spectral radius would have magnitude less than equal to norm of x. So this is what we were trying to prove in the first part here, right? Now the next thing that we are to prove is that this sigma of x is a compact set. So for that we need to prove two things. One is this set is bounded. Another thing, this set is closed. So for that, let's move on to prove this set to be compact set. So now let's see what do we have. We have considered and we have proved this thing, R sigma of x less than equal to norm of x. So using this result, we say the spectrum is bounded. That is okay, right? So we have one result, that the spectrum is bound for this to be compact. We have proved that this is bounded. So this part is done using the first result. Now we are to show this set is a closed set. So in order to prove this set to be closed set, what do we prove? The complement is an open set. And what is the complement for this spectrum set? The complement of this spectrum set is the resolvent set. So we will prove that resolvent set is an open set. So in order to prove a set as an open set, what do? We take some element from here, we calculate the neighborhood of that point, and if the neighborhood again lie completely into that set is an open set. So according to that, we take some element lambda naught from the resolvent set. So for this element, we can again define another element x minus lambda naught e. So this element has to be invertible because it follows directly from the definition for this resolvent set, because in resolvent set the vector or the element corresponding to lambda naught is invertible, is bounded, and moreover is dense in x, right? So using these properties, we can say the element x minus lambda naught e is invertible here according to the definition for resolvent set. So using this definition, we also say there is a neighborhood N which is contained in A of this element consisting of invertible elements only. This follows from the theorem that we have. If A is any complex Banach algebra with identity, then the set of all invertible elements of A is an open subset of A. Hence, the subset M, which is A minus G of all the non-invertible elements of A, is closed, right? So it follows directly from the first property here, that the set consisting of all the invertible elements is a subset of A, and moreover it is an open subset. So this forms the neighborhood of the element lambda naught consisting of invertible elements only. So keeping x as fixed, if we define a mapping lambda to another element x minus lambda e, this mapping is continuous. So we say all of x minus lambda e, where lambda is close to lambda naught, that means their distance is very small, we can take that distance to be less than delta, where delta is some positive number, that also lie in N, right? So if that is so, we can say that all these elements are invertible. Why? Because the neighborhood consists only of invertible elements. So that means the corresponding lambda belong to resolvent set also. We started with lambda naught. We considered another element lambda which is very close to this lambda naught, right? So that all the elements x minus lambda e are invertible and lie in the neighborhood of the point lambda naught, which is N, right? So this means the corresponding lambda is also lying in the resolvent set. So because we have started with lambda naught and this lambda naught was arbitrary, so this condition holds for every lambda naught. So that means we can say for every element present in the resolvent set, we have a neighborhood of lambda naught, which is an open neighborhood and which lies completely into the resolvent set. So hence this set, resolvent set, is an open set, and by by the definition of spectrum set, which is the complement of resolvent set, that is a closed set. Thus sigma of x being bounded and closed is a compact set, and this is what we wanted to prove here in this theorem, right? So in regard with this theorem, we have some remarks. The first says, so here we saw that the resolvent set, that is a non-empty set, because there exists some element corresponding to which we have invertible elements, and with the same assumptions, the set of the spectrum set, the set consisting of all the spectral values for the element x, is also non-empty. So these are two points that you should remember, right? Well, that is it for this video. Thank you for watching.